あんたならわかるでしょう。
誰からも愛されず、誰からも必要とされず、ただ孤独と向き合いながら生きていく辛さを。
Yoshitaka Mine is one of the main antagonists in Yakuza 3. He's in many ways the polar opposite of Kazuma Kiryu. Unlike Kiryu, Mine is a selfish man. He looks down on those around him. Mine believes he is superior to everyone because he has money. He is filled with greed, believing his wealth puts him above so many. Friendship is quaint to him. To Mine, everyone has a price. No one will turn down any prospect if the right amount of money is involved.Because of this, he feels like he has the right and the ability to control anyone if he has just enough money to persuade them. The only reason he was able to get into the Yakuza in the first place and rise to the top of the food chain was due to him being able to bribe the foolish Kanda. Mine bought his way into getting in a position of power. Loyalty from his peers means nothing to him. He doesn't ask for it from those around him, he simply buys it from them.Mine has had interactions with his secretary that showed him that she may be someone who cares for him, but as Mine himself was near death, he had a call from her. He thought maybe she would have proved him wrong about his views on money being the main source of power. But as he answered the phone, all she worried about was financial gain. This reaffirmed to Mine that money reigns supreme above all.
お前だけだ。俺のこと。
私だけでは判断できず、もうどうしたらよいか。例のドバイの案件の株、時価の10倍での申し込みがありました。今回の話を聞いた欧米のファンドが、会長とぜひミーティングをと依頼が殺到して。
Mine doesn't feel that those without money deserve anything. He thinks very highly of Daigo, yet he wants to put Daigo out of his misery because he can't bear to see him in such a weak and powerless state. Since Daigo being unconscious makes him have no value, he's better off dead to Mine. Being at the bottom was a waste of an existence to him. That is why he had to reach the top, to give his life meaning. Mine is firm in his pride. No one has anything of value to teach him. He has no one he can trust.Even with his superiority complex, Mine does have some redeeming qualities, even if they are expressed in a rather extreme manner. When Kanda was being a nuisance and berating Kiryu, he kills him and offers up his head to Kiryu as an apology. While barbaric and controversial, the intention behind it shows that even other people deserve his respect. Even though he hates Kiryu, what he stands for, and how Kiryu is getting in the way of his plans, he recognizes that Kiryu's status for what he's done to help the Yakuza deserves his respect. So, although Mine can be rather repugnant, he does show off some of his charisma when the opportunity arises. So then, how does a man like Mine have any redeemable qualities at all in the first place? How did he turn out this way? Mine, like Kiryu, was also an orphan. While Kiryu had the calm, collected Kazuma to look up to and instill a sense of camaraderie with, Mine's biological father wasn't the best of adult role models. Mine's father didn't like to see him wasting his free time having fun. They grew up in poverty, and his father saw fun as a waste of time. Mine was a smart kid. He got good grades, and that would impress his father. He wasn't able to get the love he wanted from his father.He wasn't able to get it from the kids around him either. He was bullied by them for being poor. He wasn't able to afford the things so he can play with the other kids, and they made fun of him for that. Later, during his father's final moments, he was told to use his brain to make something of himself. To use his intelligence to escape the poverty that caused him so much suffering. Even with his father's best of intentions from tough, strict love, Mine resented him.He doesn't even want to acknowledge him. Mine was a man of solitude since his father's passing. He only needed to rely on himself to get what he wanted. Although Mine and Kiryu were both orphans, the difference in role models caused them to walk vastly different paths. In Yakuza 3, we see the difference between pride and humility by comparing Mine to Kiryu. Mine's orphan upbringing gave him the superiority complex that he, and he alone, is responsible for anything good that happens to him. As for Kiryu, his upbringing with the gentle but firm Kazuma gave him an open mind to see how the people around him are a great asset to living his best life.Instead of using his power to go farther into the Yakuza life, Kiryu walked away from it and into a life taking care of orphan kids that needed someone to look up to. Kiryu understands the importance of community and keeping everyone happy. He knows the joys he brings onto others will be brought back to him. He does so by being there to help the kids from his orphanage, Morning Glory. Kiryu's helped Mitsuo gain confidence in himself by instilling in him that being different doesn't make him a bad person. And when Taichi was feeling down in the dumps, Kiryu took the initiative to cheer him up by putting on a wrestling show for him, and out of the kindness of his own heart, offers to take Saki in as there was a strife with the people trying to look after her. Kiryu's actions have the ability to inspire those around him. His sense of duty and responsibility helped shape the Ryudo family into better people. He has gotten Rikia and Mikio spending time with the kids in the orphanage. He's helped them build rapport and to relax more with their life. The Ryudo family boss, Nakahara, is inspired by Kiryu enough to consider him his own brother. The Ryudo family and Kiryu have become so close that they would gladly use themselves to protect Morning Glory from harm. Kiryu's kindness extends to people who are even absolutely crazy. Majima has always been a terror to be feared. His wild personality makes it difficult to predict just how he'll react. But still, Kiryu has a great deal of trust in him. Kiryu's good nature is calm enough to trust the mad dog of Shimano to keep the Yakuza he was once a part of in check. Mine doesn't like these characteristics in Kiryu. This is why he wants to get rid of him. They may share the similarity of not having their biological parents with them during their time of growth, but their clash in distrustfulness and empathy is what sets them apart. And yet, even with their differences, and with Mine's downplaying of Kiryu's strengths, he too has been touched by Kiryu's ideologies. At the end of the day, during Mine's dying breath, he believed that he had been the one who's unworthy. He decided his only way to repent is by giving up his life for Kiryu. He had wasted his life in the pursuit of power and wanted to give it up to see Kiryu prosper. He saw how Kiryu had the ability to help people cultivate better lives with his convictions. Although both Kiryu and Mine grew up orphans, they were brought up in two completely different environments. Two people dealt similar cards in the beginning, but drew very different sets, have come face to face. If the cards were switched, Mine could have been the hero of Yakuza, and Kiryu would be the one to lose his life due to his own cynicism. It just goes to show that even the best of us can do harm if we were just given the worst of luck. It brings up the question, what would have happened if Mine had met Kiryu sooner? This has been Johnny Ann. Thanks for spending time with me.
Marika wattara. Ore mo sochi ni ireru kana.